Hey folks, this is Sebastian, and today I'm going to show you how to measure the duration of a free fall using your smartphone. A while ago, I posted a video in which I demonstrated how to measure the speed of sound using your smartphone. If you missed it, check it out in the description, it's quite nice. And today we are going to use the same tool, the acoustic stopwatch. If you did not already install our app, get it for free on Android and iOS from freefox.org. In the main menu, you will find the experiment acoustic stopwatch. When you start it with the play button, it simply counts the time between two loud acoustic events. The threshold sets the volume at which it reacts. If it is too sensitive and starts because of background noise, increase the threshold. If it misses events, decrease the value. Since any noise has a certain duration and reverberation can also be above the threshold, you can adjust a minimum delay to prevent a single sound event from triggering the stopwatch multiple times. If your sound events start the stopwatch but also stop it right away, you should increase this value, but it should always be smaller than the time you want to measure. So what we want to do now is we want to drop some object and measure the time it takes from its release until the impact on the ground. To do this, we need two triggers, two sound events which indicate that the drop started and that the drop ended with the impact. With that, we can then use the acoustic stopwatch to measure the time. So let's start with a very simple setup that you can try out at home. For this simple version of the experiment, you will need three items: an object you want to drop, a ruler, and a pen or similar long object. Now place the object on the ruler, so you can hit the ruler from underneath the object. You should hit it in a way so that the object simply starts to drop without being accelerated vertically by the hit. The idea is that the hit makes a noise which starts the stopwatch, and the impact on the floor makes a second noise which stops the stopwatch again. So this setup was really simple and you can just do it at home. Only problem with this is that it's a little bit too quiet. So if you want to try it in a classroom or in front of an audience or anywhere where it's a little bit louder, you need a louder trigger sound. So for example, what we do now is we start the fall by popping a balloon. And again, the stopping sound will be the impact on the ground, but with a nice metal plate, it becomes much louder and can be detected much easier. For this setup, you will need a balloon. Attach a weight to the balloon, for example, with a hook through the mouthpiece. Create a wire loop to hold the balloon and attach it to a stand. On the floor, you should place a metal plate to increase the volume of the impact and to protect the floor if necessary. And of course, you will need a needle to pop the balloon. We will repeat this experiment a few times for different heights. The resulting times should be the root of 2 times the drop height divided by the Earth's acceleration, which is 9.81 meter per square second. So for example, a drop from 1.2 meters should take about half a second. As you can see, our results match the theory quite well, but keep in mind that there are a few sources for errors. No sound rises instantaneously above the threshold set in the app, so the different sounds of the popping balloon and the impact might have a slightly different delay when triggering the stopwatch. Also, the placement of the phone is important, as the speed of sound delays both sound events. Finally, there is a small delay between the ripping of the balloon, which produces the popping sound, and the actual collapse of the balloon, which initiates the drop. These are small errors, but they will prevent you from getting an exact match with the theory. That's it for today. If you want to learn about more smartphone experiments, check out freefox.org. Have fun with it and hope to see you next time.